Hello, everybody. Welcome to the final talk of BornHack 2020. We all hope you've had a lovely time. We certainly have, and there's a bunch of statistics and numbers about the event, and a bit about Teardown and such. First of all, like we said, we really hope you had a good time. This is probably going to be the only hacker camp you go to this year. So I hope you enjoyed it and got the most out of it. We, for the longest time, weren't sure that we were going to be able to have a BornHack this year. We only decided on June 1st that the way the corona situation in Denmark looked, it would actually be feasible to have a small BornHack, and that's what we had. We've had a great time doing it, as always. All the preparations and stuff. While it is hard work, it's also shared in a group of people who are friends and who enjoy working together. So we've enjoyed that part as well. When we arrived here on Thursday, and for the next 4 days, we went from being just the four organizers to almost 40 people helping with the build-up, which is almost a third of the participants. Which is awesome, of course. Let's do some statistics. We've been here for a week. There's all kinds of fun numbers. I'm struggling a bit with the heat, so excuse me. Okay, so we had three keynotes this year, 27 regular talks, 6 lightning talks, 12 workshops, a panel debate earlier today, 6 meetups, 4 music acts, and 5 recreational events. This is an amazing job by the content team. They've had literally zero budget this year, so there's been no possibility of getting speakers to try to pay speakers to get here. So most of the content has been from participants here, which is always fantastic. And then a few people have visited us through the week. So very nice, and I hope you've all seen the event feedback button in the program. You can go into each event and submit your opinion of the event and a comment, and we can use that to make the program even better next year, because we want to invite the people back who did a great job, and we can only know if you inform us. So please do so. We had an awesome badge this year. Again, this was done very last minute and very, very much on a budget. Amazing job by the badge team. 156 badges completed, 289 LEDs per badge. All 156 badges had some error on it that had to be manually fixed after. So the badge team were busy doing that. That's 45,000 LEDs, and we've had pull requests through the week with cool stuff. There's a snake game and all kinds of things. We would love for you to keep hanging on them and submit more stuff, and you can keep an eye on the Git repo and see if exciting new stuff comes in. We'll happily accept pull requests for cool stuff. The network has been running great this year. The NOC team are very coordinated, they are very prepared, they had this up and running the day after I think we arrived, and it's been running since, including the construction to get the fiber over the main road that many of you might have driven under, consisting of 2 flagpoles and some concrete circuits for them, and then the fiber in the air. It's an amazing job, and we reached 200 Wi-Fi clients. About half of them disappear at night, so those are probably the laptops. The rest are probably phones. We had a lot more traffic this year than last year. 10 times more upload than in 19. Maybe this has something to do with the Tor exit nodes. Maybe not, but it is awesome. Anyway, we peaked at 850 megabits download, and we have a gigabit, so we are nearing the capacity, and we're looking into whether we can upgrade this to 10 gigabit for next year, but the price tag is a bit steep right now, but we're looking at it. We also reached an impressive temperature of 58 degrees Celsius in the pub in the info desk one day. It's been hot for all the equipment, of course, but it's been running great. So very well done to the NOC team. The bar, as always, has been a fantastic place, beautiful and nice to be, and they've of course sold a lot because it's been hot, so people need cool drinks to exist. And we've sold 212 liters of Mate and 400 liters of beer. And we've outsold last year, even though we have less than half the number of participants, which is pretty amazing because, and I guess, yes, well done everybody. We are very dependent on some earnings from the bar to make ends meet in the budget, and so we really appreciate the people. You're absolutely welcome to go buy stuff in the supermarket, but we appreciate it when you use the bar because we can use the earnings from it to make everything work. Remember, the bar is open tonight, so if you have some hex left, then you know where to go. So the token game was on again this year. 22 secret tokens were hidden, 187 total finds, and four of the tokens were a bit too difficult apparently. They were not found by anyone. 35 people found at least one token, and the winner of a ticket for next year was Sebastian with 16 tokens. Is he here? Well done. Yes, and the token game is fun, and we now have the game team for managing that for next year. So it's bound to be even more fun tokens and other games in the coming years. So everything up until we arrive, or a week before or so, is done by the core Orga team. We are 10 people. But as soon as we get closer to Bornhagen, especially when we arrive on the venue, we need help from volunteers, and so many of you have helped, and we felt it would be a good idea to have people stand up if you've helped on a team to this year, just to illustrate how many of this random selection of people actually helped. And let's have a big round of applause for everybody. It is very appreciated that the people show up early to help. It's appreciated the people who jump in and do something during the week, small and big jobs. And it is also appreciated when people help for teardown, because that needs to be done too, of course. Oh, that's a beautiful segue. Teardown. We need help with all the usual stuff. Consider, if you can, staying around a day or two. It helps us a lot to have more hands. We have food. Jonathan will be cooking, as he did during build-up, and the people who were there knows that that he is an awesome chef. So there will be food, and there will be bar leftovers. So usually it's hard work, but fun. And we start tomorrow at 1 with a meeting in the workshop rooms, which by then are converted to sort of build-up facility or teardown facility. So if you were going to help out during teardown, please be there at 1 tomorrow. The first shared teardown meal will be at 7 tomorrow, and meal times will be at 9, 1 and 7, just like during build-up. There is somebody just raised an issue that since the food vendor is leaving today, then there will be no lunch for people to buy tomorrow, and everybody will have to cook for themselves for lunch. We may, I don't know, we'll talk about what we'll do about that. Anyway, we have the venue until Friday, but we hope and think that we'll be able to get most stuff packed down by Thursday. The tents, this and the other tents, the white ones, are getting forklifted and packed into the lorry in the parking area on Thursday. And the lorry itself is picked up Friday, and all the power stuff goes in there too. So we aim to have power throughout the day tomorrow, but from Wednesday expect the power to disappear, and the network will probably disappear tomorrow from 12. If you are staying for teardown, be there tomorrow at 1 is the gist of it. Then we'll take the details there. We really want to hear your feedback, not just for the events, as I said, but also for Born Hack itself. What was good? What could be better? We have the feedback section on the website, and it is very appreciated if you take time, while you can still remember everything, to write us a few lines and tell us what was good and what wasn't. If you are missing anything, go to the info desk. If you found something, go to the info desk. There's a lost and found, and the more stuff we can get sorted now while people are here, the better, so we don't need to be mailing stuff around the world after Born Hack. Like I said, our food vendor Curtis leaves today at 8. We feel like it worked out great with him. It was delicious food and plenty of it, and we hope that he will be coming back next year. Yes. Okay. As is tradition at these Born Hack events, we want to take down the speaker's tent immediately following this. So when this talk is done, we will empty the tent and then start tearing it down. This is a pretty quick job if we all help, and especially if people listen to the yellow vests, and we can do it in a safe and fast manner. We brought a bunch of masks, so if you're, we are going to be working a bit in close proximity, so please come and get a mask, and you, and yeah. So all the chairs go into the Avis car on the road, at the end of the road, where the road to food area is. All the tables need to be folded and stacked on the pallets out here. The sides, the cloths need to be folded inside, towards inside, and stacked on the other pallets, and so does the roof. And then finally, the metal skeleton needs to be stacked in the metal crates that are for that. All the yellow vests know how to pack stuff. They know where it goes, and it's better to ask, because we usually wind up moving stuff at least once more because it's either been packed wrongly or just put in the way. So we need to be able to get in and out of the road, so don't place stuff there. And in general, just if you have a question, just ask, and we'll be happy to tell you what to do. But you can all start by taking the chair you're sitting on and bringing it to the Avis car, or maybe stack a few and bring them to the Avis car, and then all the tables out and folding them, and then the tent tear down itself, speak to the yellow vests. This should take... we used to time it. It'll probably be a bit slower this year because we have to keep our distance still. But it should take no more than 20-30 minutes or so if everybody gives a hand. And after that, we could also use some help with a couple of village tents in the main camping area. But this is the primary one because it's too big to do just a couple of people. We need to crowdsource the shit out of it. So I hope that... that everybody is up for helping a little bit with this. We would have hired people to do it, but we did not have the money for it. We also have the traditional burning of this speaker's chair. We burned it the first year for some reason I can't really remember, and then it just became a tradition. And so even though it is a very nice speaker's chair, we are absolutely going to burn it. So that's happening on main camping tomorrow at 11 in the big fireplace there, not the one behind Noisy, the one in general camping across from the info desk ish. So you probably know and some maybe already feel a bit of the post camp blues. It is a pretty normal thing. I think everybody knows the feeling when an awesome event is nearing the end. It is a real thing, and it can be rough, but you can remedy it by watching some of the talks you missed. You can play with your badge and submit a cool pull request with something. You can take the pictures you've taken, hopefully with everybody's permission, and if you find some cool pictures, then please send them to us. We want to see them. you can stay in touch with all your new friends and old friends. And we're putting the Born Hack 2021 tickets for sale. So you can always buy a ticket for Born Hack 2021 from starting today. And keep hacking. Next year, from the 11th to the 18th of August 2021, which leaves enough time that the MCH, which is in the Netherlands, is well over, and you can go straight from there to help with the Born Hack build-up. And hopefully by then we'll have some sort of vaccine or something for this corona shit, so we can have a more regular-sized and normal event. Oh, shit. Yeah, these are not the dates, but find them on the website. Sorry about that. Yeah, that's it. We love you all. We hope you enjoyed it yourself. Thank you for showing up. We'll see you next year. We'll see you at the bar later, and we'll see you right after this for taking down the speaker's tent. Thank you all.